Probability lesson number four. Today we're going to look at outcomes, sample space, and a little bit revision from last lessons, just to see how much you remember. So let's have a look. Please prepare for the class. You need a pen, a notebook, and your completed homework sheet from last time, which was about cards. So if you can quickly find this worksheet. Now, if you don't have it, perhaps you can use your notebook to write some answers. We'll have a look at some answers first, and then we move on with our new lesson. Okay, if you need more time to get some stuff, please pause this. Now, for this lesson, you will need these two sheets. Hopefully, you had time to print them out. These are the homework sheets that you will have to do after this lesson. If you don't have these sheets, you can copy the questions later on. At the end of this lesson, I will show you these sheets again, and you can copy them into your notebook. Now, let's check the homework first. So, we had six questions here about cards. First question, what is the probability of picking an ace from a deck of cards? So, ace is the card here, the one that's got A. So there are four ace cards, okay, so 4 over 52, or 1 over 13, and we divide 100 by 13 and we get 7.7% probability, which is unlikely. Question 2, a number less than 4 from a deck of cards. Now there are 8 numbers that are less than 4. We write that 8 over 52, or 2 over 13, we divide 100 by 13 and multiply by 2, and we get 15.4%. Chance probability, which is still unlikely. Now the next one, a face card from a deck of cards. Now there are 12 face cards. So we put 12 over 52 or 3 over 13 and we get 23%, which is still unlikely. The other one is a spade from a deck of cards. Now a spade is this one, okay, the one that I'm pointing at here. So we have 13 over 52, which is 1 over 4, 25% chance, unlikely. Now the next one is an 8 or a 9 from a deck of cards. So we add 8 and 9s and we have 8 cards of those. So 8 over 52 or 2 over 13, which is 15.4%, unlikely. And the last question, bonus questions. If two jokers are present in a deck of cards, so this is a joker here, there are two of them. What is the probability of picking one joker? Now we have two jokers, and we have, then instead of having 52 cards, we have 54. So we write 2 over 54, and should be 1 over 27, or 3.8%, which is very low. Now this is the homework from last time. Please check it. If you need more time, pause this lesson. Okay, hopefully everyone is doing all right. Now, let's move on with some other things we need to do for today. So, if you can please open your notebook and look at this sample space. So, the title is sample space, and what it means, the sample space is the collection of all possible events. So, for example, all six faces of a die. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All 52 cards of a bridge deck, okay? Now, so a sample space, you need to write down sample space, and then you need to write down the sample space is the collection of all possible events or things that can happen. So when you roll a dice, you can roll any of these combinations. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the sample space for rolling a dice, and this is sample space for cards. So please pause this lesson if you need more time and open your notebook and write down sample space and what it means. Now you can also write an example. Okay, now you need to know these. I will possibly ask you later to see if you know these terms. So if you write this into your notebook, you will be able to use this for your test. Okay, so please write this down. Okay. So a sample space, as we said, is the set of all possible outcomes in an experiment, okay? Example, if we have two coins and we toss two coins. We can show this in three different ways. So this is, these are our sample spaces. We can list them. So we can have two heads, heads and tails, tails and heads, and two tails. We can put it in a table like this as well, and we can do a tree diagram, which we will look at next lesson. So we can have heads, tails, and then heads, tails, heads, tails. Okay, and then heads, 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 tails, tails, heads, tails, tails. So we can show these in three different ways. So this is our sample spaces. So the sample spaces is this, basically all the possible outcomes, okay? Now, the next thing we need to know is what outcome is. So also write down outcome, and it's one possible result of an experiment. Okay, so it's one possible result of an experiment. So for example, if we roll a die and we roll two, this is our outcome. If we roll two dices and we get four and six, this is our outcome. Okay, so a sample space, let's go back, shows all the possible outcomes, okay? And outcome is one possible result. So one, we roll the dice and we get two, or we roll two dices and we get four and six. So please pause this lesson and you can write this down. Outcome, just one possible result of an experiment. Now, let's look at this example. A child's game has three pictures. If you choose a card, replace it and choose again, how many different combinations could you get? Now we have a cat, we have a dog, and we have a mouse. Now, if we pick two cards, what combinations could we get? Okay, so we, for example, pick a card with a dog and we put it back and we pick another card with a dog. So we have, one of the outcomes we can have is dog. Then we pick a dog, we put it back and we pick another card and we get a cat. So we can have a dog and a cat. Okay, now think about what other outcomes we can have. Okay, so these are the two possible outcomes. Now, if you can think about a little bit about some other ones, what could be the other ones before I show you the answer? So you can quickly write in your notebook what you think other outcomes could be. Okay, now if you need a bit more time, you can pause this and have a look. So just look, these are the two possible outcomes. What other ones can you have? Now remember, every time we pick a card, we put it back. Now let's have a look. So there actually are nine different outcomes. Now we can have a dog on a dog, we can have a dog and a cat, a dog and a mouse, and then we have a cat and a dog, so we can pick a cat first and then a dog. We can have two cats and we can have cat and mouse, and we have a mouse and a dog, a mouse and a cat, and two mice. And then this is our all the possible outcomes, or a sample space. Okay, so DD, DC, and we can shorten these and write it like this. Now, so this is our sample space. Okay, all the possible outcomes. And you can also draw a table and put them like this. Now, we have a question. What is the probability of getting matching cards? Okay, so matching cards. We have three probabilities, so three favorable outcomes. So there are nine possible outcomes altogether, and the matching cards would be DD, CC, or MM. They are both the same. So we write 3 over 9, and we get 1 over 3. Now, next question, what's the probability of getting a dog card? Now we need to have a look which cards have a dog. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five over nine, okay? So this is our probability of getting a dog card. And these are written in fractions. Again, this is a sample space. And then these are outcomes. So there are nine outcomes, and this is all of the outcomes are a sample space. Now let's have a look at this. Keep your notebook open. So let's have a look at rolling two dice. So if you roll the first dice, you can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you roll a second one, you can also have the same. Now, what outcomes we can have when we roll two dice? Now, I'd like you to finish filling this. Now, you don't have to draw a table, but you can just write, like, list them in a line in your notebook. So the first two columns are done. So 1-1, 1-2, 1-3, 1-4, 1-5, 1-6, and 2-1, 2-2, 2-3, 2-4, 2-5, 2-6. Now, can you write down what other outcomes we can have when you roll two dice? So this should be easy for you. So just make a list in your notebook. What other outcomes we can have? And then we will check the answer. Now, if you need a bit more time, you can pause this lesson, okay? I will move on to the next thing soon and I will show you the answers. Okay, now let's check. So these are the rest of the outcomes. So we have 3, 1. So for example, we roll dice 1, we get 3, we roll dice 2, we can have 1, and these are the possible outcomes. Now just have a look and finish filling this in, okay? Now you can just list them. So there are 36 possible outcomes, and this is our sample space. Okay, it's shown like this, all the possible outcomes. Now, the next three questions. So just keep your notebook open, and if you can think about this. First question, 10 different sweets are in a bag. If one is chosen, how many outcomes are there? So how many possible outcomes? There are 10 different sweets. Please write down how many possible outcomes you can have. Now, next question. There are 15 students in a class. One is chosen. How many outcomes are there? So remember, outcomes are all the possible things. So if there are 15 students and one is chosen, how many choices can we have? Okay, this is the next question. And question number three. Three red counters, two blue counters, and one white counter are in a bag. One is chosen. How many outcomes are there? So how many altogether? Now just take your time. If you need more time to answer these questions, please pause this lesson and we will check the answers now. So there are 10 different suites. So our total number of outcomes are 10. There are 15 students and only one is chosen. So we have 15 students or 15 different choices. And this one we had to add. So 3 plus 2 plus 1, we have 6. There are 6 different outcomes we can have. Okay, now let's have a look at this other question. When we are trying to decide what to wear, we can also use probability, okay, and we can use these types of diagrams to solve our problems. So we have all of these lovely shirts, okay, and we have pants. Now we have 5 different shirts and we have 4 different pants. How do we know how many different outfits can we get? Now it's very simple. We basically take all the outfits, all the shirts on one side and all the pants on the other side and multiply them together. So we multiply 5 by 4 and we get 20. So 20 possible outcomes. Okay? So this is one of the things one of the rules. So we multiply together. Now let's have a look at this. So if you have 6 different shirts on that side and 3 different pants on this side, can you think about how many different outfits can we have now? Just think about it, pause this lesson, and I will show you the answer. Just from looking at this, okay, let's go back to this one. We have 20 different outfits. Can you please write down how many outfits can you get from this? Now, the answer is 6 multiplied by 3, 18 outfits. Okay, there are 6 different shirts and 3 different pants. We multiply those together and we get 18 outfits. All right. Now, we are doing a lot of work in your notebook, so just keep it open. Can you please list all the outcomes for tossing free coins? Now, I want you to have a look at this diagram. So, we have a first coin, and then a second coin, and a third coin. Okay, and this is a tree diagram. We will look at it next time. And these, where are the outcomes? So if you could just find those outcomes and make a list. Okay, all the possible outcomes. Now this is our sample space, all the outcomes, but you need to list them, write them down. Okay, now let's check. So hopefully you noticed this, the outcomes are actually written here. So very easy to find outcomes, and we have 8 different outcomes. Now, last lesson, we looked at a question where you had to choose, okay, would you rather flip 3 coins or roll 3 dice? Now, let's look at this question again. Can anyone spot a mistake in the answer? So this was the answer. You can have 3 heads, 3 tails, or heads, heads, tails, 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 heads. Now, can anyone think about a possible mistake in this? Now, I might have written this mistake on purpose, just to see if you can understand, and I was going to tell you more about the outcomes. So I want you to have a look. Can you see any difference? So both of these are showing possible outcomes for tossing 3 coins. Now we just looked at this diagram, and this is the answer I gave you. Now, do you think it's the correct answer, or can you see a mistake? What do you think? Now you can pause this and think about it, and we will check in a minute. Now let's have a look. So there should be 8 outcomes and not 4. Now, the mistake was that I did not write the rest of the 4 outcomes, okay? So you needed to add heads, tails, heads, okay? Tails, heads, tails, tails, and tails, heads, heads. Now, there are 8 outcomes altogether. That actually changes the chance of winning to 25%. So you're at 2 over 8. And 1 over 4, we have 25% of chance of winning when we are flipping coins. So there's definitely much higher chance for rolling the dice. We had about over 50% for that one. So if you choose dice, around 50% chance of winning. And if you choose coins, around 25%. So if you've done your experiment for that one, hopefully you all got dice winning. I definitely always, as many times as I did, dice was winning. Okay, let's move on. Now, we are doing a lot of writing this time, but after this we will do a quick Jeopardy game. So we will do something different. So the next thing we're going to look at is, what is a favorable outcome? Okay, and write this down. Is the result that you want to get? Okay, so basically, for example, you want this spinner to land on yellow. Yellow is a favorable outcome. Okay, so if you have a spinner 4 different colors and you want to get yellow, yellow is a favorable outcome. The probability of landing on yellow is 1 in 4 or 1 over 4 because there's 4 different outcomes and you want just one. Okay, now just pause this and write down, please. Favorable outcome is the result that you want to get. So just one sentence, okay? And write down favorable outcome, because you need to know that favorable outcome is the result that you want to get. And sorry, you can pause this and just write this down. Now, question. List favorable outcomes for getting an even number on a dice. Open your notebook and copy this. So, these are the possible outcomes. So you can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, what are the favorable outcomes? So you want to get an even number. Now you need to remember what an even number is. So we have odd numbers and even numbers. So I'll give you a little bit of time to think. which numbers out of these are even? And we will check the answer in a minute. Okay, so the favorable outcomes or the even numbers will be 2, 4, and 6. Now, you have 3 favorable outcomes, okay? So, 3 possible outcomes you need to get. Over 6 possible outcomes. So, you need to get an even number, so you write 3 because you have 3 favorable outcomes over 6. 6 possible outcomes. So, you get a 50% equal chance. Okay? Now, hopefully, you will remember what even number is. Yes? Okay. Now, next question. Here is a number spinner. What is the probability of spinning a number that is bigger than 3? Identify favorable outcomes. Now, if you can think about this, and we will check the answer. So the question is, you need to get a number bigger than 3. So what numbers do you need to get? What are the favorable outcomes? So you can pause this and we will check. Now the favorable outcomes would be number 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. All of these numbers are bigger than 3. So we will have 5 favorable outcomes out of 8. So the probability would be 5 over 8. Okay, let's listen to the song. Now, you can sing along a little bit, maybe not too loud if your parents are around, but just for a little bit of break and relax, we're just gonna listen to this. I threw my hands up in the air sometimes to say it. Gonna let you know the probability of something cool taking place. So baby, let's go. So what's the chance? I toss a coin and it lands on the side that will fix my plans. I don't want it, but I want tails. Yeah, so I'm thinking through possibilities. Yeah, I throw my hands up in the air sometimes, saying damn, gonna let you know the probability of something cool taking place. So baby, let's go. There are two possibilities. The coin can land either heads or tails. It's not the ability in one of those two choices. So what's the chance? The card I picked from the standard pack. Is an ace, there are four pieces out of 52 cards. Yeah, so I'm thinking the standard pack for an ancient So hopefully you had a bit of a break. Now we are going to look very quickly at a few more questions before we finish this lesson. Now, if you can open your notebooks or keep your notebooks open, hopefully you still have them there. Now let's have a look if you can remember this. So what is this line called? Okay, if you can think about it. Now, you probably wouldn't remember how to spell it, but just try. So write down in your notebook what you think this line is called. Okay, now it's called a probability scale or line. Okay, you can say probability line, you can also say probability scale. So two possible answers. So just quickly write this down. Now, next one. How can probability be written? So there are three ways. How can you show a probability? Let's have a look. So as a fraction, 1/6. So if you're trying to get a 2 on a dice, you can write it as 1/6. As a decimal, 16 hundredths, or as a percent, 16%. So there are three different ways to express probability. Okay, now next question. So now you can pause this if you need more time. Find probability of choosing dark color pants, so blue and black. Now let's have a look at the picture on the right. So probability is written in a small in a capital letter P, and we need to find the probability of getting pulling out blue or black pants. Now we need to decide what our favorable outcomes and what are the total possible outcomes, and write it over as a fraction. So look at this picture and perhaps count how many different pants there are, and then you need to see how many blue and black pants are there. Okay, so just think about it. We'll check the answer in a minute. You can pause this as well and let's have a look. So there are three black pants and two blue. So we add them and we get five altogether. There are eight possible outcomes and there are five favorable outcomes. So if you write it as 5/8 and then 100 divided by 8 and multiply by 5, we have about 63%. Now it's more than 50%, so it's quite likely we're going to get the dark color pants. So probability is much more than half, okay? So it's not bad. So just have a look at this one. Hopefully you understand this type of question. Now, next question. Alex and Mark want to play baseball. They want to decide who bats first, so they flip a coin. Alex calls heads. What is the probability he will win? So just remember tossing a coin. What is the probability? Hopefully this will be easy for you. So the answer should be 50%. So we don't know if it's going to be heads or tails. Now, one more question. Derek has a hat container. The box contains 7 blue hats, 5 green hats, and 8 red hats. Without looking, if Derek chooses a hat from a container, what is the probability of selecting a green cap? What is the probability of selecting a blue or red hat? Now, this is the question. Okay, so just think about it. Okay, there are three different hats, three different colors. Now, Derek wants to select a green cap, perhaps. What is the probability of him getting that cap? And what is the probability of selecting a blue or red hat? Okay, you can pause this if you need a bit more time and just try and answer this in your notebook. So you need to get the total of all caps or hats. So 7 plus 5 plus 8 is 20. Then we know we have 5 green caps. So we need to write it as a fraction, 5/20 and 1/4. So it's 25% of getting a green cap. So it's unlikely. Now, question B was what is the probability of getting a blue and red cap? So we add those, 7 plus 8, 15. Then the total is 20. So we write 15 over 20 and it's 3 over 4, which is 75%. And it's quite likely that he might get a blue or red cap. Okay, we don't have time for Jeopardy questions this time, so we'll do it next lesson. The last thing we need to do is look at the homework. So you should have these sheets. If you don't have them, you can stop this lesson and see if you can copy these. I will also send a PDF, okay, a sheet to the WeChat group. So you can open it on your phone as well. If you can't print it, perhaps you can copy it from your phone. You will see it better. So this is our lesson for today, guys. If you have any questions, please let me know. And please do this homework, take pictures and send it to me. Okay, guys, goodbye and I will talk to you soon.